Scarab's blessing with an appeasement in the first hand. Well, it doesn't matter where I'd play my Ra, right? Because I think I just do this. Then I appeasement it next turn. Because that doesn't have a time limit on it. It's just resurrects if killed. Yes, auto me. If he autos me, that's great because it deals an extra damage. Okay. He's smart. So actually, do I ward this turn? I think I actually ward and then appeasement next turn. Because it hits more targets. And he's not going to kill me this turn. Hit me. Oh, please hit me. He hit me. That's bad. Yeah, he should not be hitting me. This means I can put him at 4 HP. Which isn't huge, but I mean, it's still important.
The sun has risen once again.
I could actually appeasement twice. I'm not going to, though. And then Sobek. I'll stick him in the back. It's more targets for that to ping. This is a good target to ping. Never know. Might be able to heal it some. Buff it up a little. I can want more card draw before I use the other appeasement. And it was only one mana, so I can fit it in almost anywhere. Rushing Thunder. Trying to ping my Ra. Fair enough. Crescent Blade trying to ping the Ra or the Sobek. And misses. Feels like he should have done that next turn when he's got the 5-2. He's gonna use the mana potion to ping Ra. He's got another Manifold Blade he's gonna ping with. Oh my goodness. That just seemed clunky and bad. Not even gonna lie. This is gonna force me to answer this turn though. That's gonna be a 3-5 Sobek. He's just used a hell of a lot of spells. But this is a permanent buff. Which is plus 4 movement. So this is 7 movement. It can't get here. It's the only place that mother cannot get. So I'm pretty sure I have to baboon, right? Which means I lose a stone. But I can kill the 6-2 next turn. Which is mad value. That's fine. Double white tiger. Oh, if I draw into annihilation. Right, well, we're pretty much always drawing. We are always drawing. That's out of range. Of course it is. Well, there's no reason to leave the white tiger alive. I want to play the Departed this turn, because then it draws me a card. He's got one. Well, he's got to kill that first. So, Crescent Blade, boom. Yeah, no, he can't win next turn. Without Dragon King. He can win with Dragon King, right? No, because I moved the baboon up one. If I did not do that, he could. the stone, which is unfortunate. That was gonna happen. 7-2 has pretty much got to kill my baboon. That's disgusting. He can't win the game, though. Yeah, I hope he leaves the baboon up, because I can appease him, the baboon. He shouldn't, though. He should kill it. Yeah. He's representing 4 damage on board. Do we need healing stat? I think we do.
The sun has risen once again.
Oh, I can't count. Oh, God. If I do that, that'll be a 1 cost to go. So, yeah, I think that is actually the correct line. It doesn't matter if I discount the other ones at this point. See, he's still low on cards. I pretty much need to hit Annihilation. Oh, well, that probably seals me. Not this turn, but. I do have 2 executes. Let's think for a minute. You are dying. Because that represents at least 3 damage. Now there are two lines here. Well, no, I think that's the only good line. And then put you here because it can remove the 1-2. No, it can't, because now it's 1-3. Regardless. Alright. One of them gets swallowed. Well, it's still a 1-3. If he draws Transfuse and I auto lose. Oh, hello there. Well, yeah, I do that. Best option right there. Still, I gotta lose to Transfusion. But not as hard.
The sun has risen once again.
That's happening. Oh, well, I should have played the Sobek first. Actually, no, I'm playing Departed, so it didn't matter. So I can... No, Departed's better. So it's coming out next turn, though. I have 8 mana represented. I've got 8 good draws in my deck. Let's see, what do I have in my deck right now? I've got Phantom, one Decrepit, 2 BDKs, 1 Baboon, Blade Master, an Anubis. Yeah, that dies. Should be able to win this now. Transfusion. I still need to dodge transfusion. But I've drawn so much more on my deck than he has that I think I can dodge it. There's the Anubis that I needed. Reasoning here is I need to remove his board, and again, transfusion is what I'm dodging, so I value hitting the Chang'e over hitting the stone because it removes 4 damage. I don't have to worry about Dragon King, so I can line up like that, and this dies next turn to Ra. Game next turn anyway, so there we go. Alright, well, I'm starting to understand that deck a little bit better, but it is about 1:30 in the morning, and I think I'll sleep on it. Try to play this deck and then the greed deck some tomorrow, take a peek how those turn out.